club on the ground. His hands are turned to the right a little bit more than maybe they should, which would make him very, very susceptible to delivering the club face in a closed position, like this. Because it's easy, when your hands are on this side of the club, it's really easy to turn it this way. No different if your hands were this way, it would be hard to turn the club face this way. So what it is, do you fear left or right?
Left.
Left, that makes sense. So, because it's easy for him to close the club face, it's easy for him to close the club face, so his fear is left. So what do you think he's going to do with his swing? He's going to swing to the right. You always swing in the opposite direction of your fear. So slicers, which most people in the audience are, I guarantee you, fear right, so they swing left. The only problem is that makes it worse. As we say in America, that's like throwing water on a grease fire. So when you've got grease on fire, you don't want to throw water on it, it makes it worse. So what happens with Matty is that his fear is left because of his grip being turned to the right. So he holds the club from closing on the downswing. So the bad right shot is when he doesn't let this square up. He holds the club face off, as we term it, and it's to the right, and then the ball goes to the right. So when he gets up on a hole, he doesn't know whether it's going to go this way or this way. And so long term for him, I would probably move that grip a little bit more what we call a neutral position. And to where it's in the fingers of his right hand, and then also move it a little bit weaker. What about your trajectory? Did you hit it high or low, or what do you think?
It's kind of pretty standard.
Well, with, as hard as he hits it, he should have said high, because he has more spin than the next guy. If he hit it standard, that means you got a lot of shaft length. Now, we're going to try to get a video here. Let's go, let me try that again.